I've always been interested in the idea of lasers and how one can be useful in the workshop. Laser engravings are everywhere once you recognise them, on machine accessories, tools, and even everyday items. Full disclosure, Omtech gave me this laser to try out. This is a fibre laser. It consists of the laser source in this box, which beams a laser through optical fibre to the laser head. It uses mirrors to zip the laser around quickly to engrave parts. Let's try some basic tests before looking at exciting uses and getting experimental. What I can tell you is the laser engraving quality is very clean and very fast depending on the material and the settings. Stainless and brass develop a really nice contrast, but other metals are perfectly fine. Fibre lasers are generally for metal and some plastics. Just make sure your settings aren't too high in the plastic. The laser will strip off powder coat and paint, but it really produces a lot of fumes. Even when engraving bare metal, there's a distinctive smell in the air, not unlike TIG welding. By playing with settings, it's possible to engrave different shades on some metals, and I'd love to try titanium if I had some. These machines are not really for wood, but you can get basic results at a pinch. Apart from logos, what can you use a laser for? One of the basic uses is marking identification on stock and parts, but I've got other ideas. My surface grinder has two different threads, one left hand and one right hand, and it gets confusing. Marking a tightened direction solves this issue. I recently mounted rulers in my drill press fence, however, the process would have been far simpler if I had this laser at the time. One feature of this laser that I find really interesting is a foot pedal. This can be useful for spamming your logo or repeat production runs. As a heads up, I'm slowly working on rotary brooches in the background, and I'll announce more in time. Let's talk software. The laser comes with EasyCAD 2. At first glance, it's a terrible interface, but it can actually do a lot fairly easily. It has basic shape drawing tools, image and vector import capability, shapes can be hatched to fill them in, and in a very short time, you can make a decent design. Text can be manipulated like word art into curves, and I can see this being useful. The laser has a rotary axis attachment. While the chuck is small, anything is possible with clever work holding. Say if I wanted a large hand wheel dial, I can make an arbor to overcome the work holding limitation. I'm going to create this dial in EasyCAD. I'll create it quickly just to give you an idea of what you can do with the software. My first engraving was perhaps a bit faint, and I forgot the final block of tick marks. I skimmed it off and tried again with slower and deeper engraving. The results are much better. I deliberately overshot the final tick mark to demonstrate the accuracy, and the tick mark perfectly aligned. While these lasers are for engraving, it turns out you can cut materials with the right settings. Even thin metals can be cut with a bit of patience and enough passes. I tested to see if the laser can be used for mill scale removal. It certainly strips it, but it will leave a coloured surface, so perhaps isn't that useful. The laser will remove rust, however, there are far more effective methods. Now for another test. Cold bluing benefits from a textured surface, so I figured why not an engraved hatching? This test piece has a lasered area, a blank area, and a sandblasted area for comparison. I perform my usual cold bluing techniques, and then place the steel in a soothing oil bath overnight. I'll confess, this isn't the greatest cold blue finish, but the results are still clear. The laser preparation gave the best results, followed by sandblasting, and no preparation was definitely the worst. Scrubbing with the Scotch-Brite shows that the deeper laser engraving is much more durable, and it's possible to get good contrast in the crevices, like in the text here. Now to test the reverse. I have a cold blued finish, and I want to engrave it. The text comes out very clear with really nice contrast. I also tested some different settings on a large hatch area, and again, it results in very good contrast. The laser is accurate and well built. The only downside is it's heavy and bulky. The box states it requires a forklift to move, but I found two people can pick it up fairly easily. I really was amazed at the speed of the laser engraving process. If you mark things often, it's definitely a time saver. This laser does have a really good working area, and the M6 tapped holes are very useful for jig setups. It's probably not a tool for everyone, but there is a discount code below if you're interested.